near this building where Barnes Wallace worked and where two of his bombs stand sentry, A.V. Rowe built and flew Britain's first flying machine. The building recommended for scheduling as an ancient monument was the clubhouse of Brooklands. Not only was this the cradle of British aviation, the track is pretty dilapidated now, but the Brooklands Society hopes to change all that. The vice president and a man who raced here regularly is Alan Hess. What are the Society's plans for preserving Brooklands?
Well, we have two stages, really. The first is we want as much as possible of the historic features of the place to be preserved. We would like very much to establish a national transport museum here with land, sea and air exhibits, some of which will be working models. But ultimately, our real ambition possibly can never be... never come to light, but we hope it will, would be to establish a leisure centre with every kind of facility for athletics, gymnasium, indoor swimming pool, tennis and so on, so that our athletes who compete overseas in places like the Olympics can have really good facilities for training, which are so lacking at the moment.
The cars behind us are beautiful looking cars and they seem well made. What do you know about these cars and can they be ridden now around the track?
Oh, yes, indeed. They're all competing regularly in club events of all kinds and so on. They cost a lot to maintain, of course, because it's difficult to get spare parts, a lot of which have to be made by hand. But they all belong to enthusiasts who have fairly deep pockets. And it's their principal interest in life to keep them going and have fun with them.
You must have memories of tearing round this track. I notice some of these cars have got rather strange exhausts.
Ah, great cumbersome things, yes. That results from the denizens of St. George's Hill about in the late 1920s objecting to the noise. And they got some sort of a petition together and got it signed and got an injunction on cars running here without these cumbersome silencers are.
St. George's Hill people were fussy in those days.
Oh, very, yeah.
Now, these cars, the MG and the others, what are their make? I know the MG at the right at the beginning, the first one. What are the others, their makes?
There's an ERA. They are an English car which swept the board for a couple of years before the war in racing. Bugatti, French car, beautiful looking little thing, a real racing-looking car. And, of course, this famous Bentley, which belonged to Sir Henry Birkin, and has a wonderful history.
Did it go at a good speed?
Oh, yes. It was built for this track.
What was the speed of this one?
This one was somewhere up in the 130s it used to lap at.
130-odd miles an hour. Did you have to be specially strapped in when you went? Because it looks a bumpy, dangerous track.
Bumpy? I'll say it's bumpy. We had to wear sort of almost corsets, body belts anyway, to keep our guts in place when we raced around here.
Surgical belts?
Surgical belts, yes.
Is it really that rough?
It really was, yes.
Do you think that...
A long-distance race was hell. 500 miles, I mean,
really
took toll of you, yes.
Do you think some of your enthusiasts, I know they're big veterans, but would they still race around this track if they could?
Rather.
Well, I'd like
I
to
would
see
if I could.
You really would.
But I'm senile.
Well, I wouldn't say that at all. I think you're very active. Mr. Hess, thank you very much.
Thank you.
The Brooklands slogan was the right crowd and no crowding. It might well be the Weybridge town motto today.